confidently, aggressively going for this shot, but as a chopper does, he told me Sato loads it with spin.
Yeah, there's a lot of variation in spin in every defensive shot that she plays. It looks the same, but it's not.
Well, that confidence shows here. She finds the deep corner and, well, beats Hitomi Sato on the wide wing.
One of the very few defensive players around. We don't see that many, but Wang Yidi is going to have to play a patient game. She's going to have to play a waiting game. She has to attack the correct ball. She can't just go and play powerful shots on every shot.
That said, when Hitomi Sato comes into attack, she's not playing to rally, she's playing to win.
And when a defensive player starts to attack, you kind of back off. You get a little bit uptight.
It's a very different style of attack than they're used to. That's a flatter shot. Not as much topspin on it. Now, can you tell us about why you see defenders serving with their backhand a little bit more?
I think they're just kind of standing at the center of the table. Just different kinds of spin. I think she's more the backhand side server. We don't see her serving too many times from the forehand. But the defensive player, the position is on the is at the center of the table so that she has enough width on the forehand and the backhand just to return short. She cannot afford to go towards one side of the table. Otherwise, she's going to leave a lot of the other side uncovered.
Showing that she's not afraid to attack here. If the serve comes a little bit loose or a little bit long, she'll look for that early winning point, or the shot that will win her the point, rather. So with the first towel break, towel breaks come up every 6 points. These two, dead even. Some impressive underspin from the long pips in a push rally, meaning when Wang Yidi gives underspin to Hitomi Sato, from time to time you'll see Sato twiddle the racket to generate more spin off the sticky black side.
She plays that side spin shot very well, the one that moves away from Yidi's forehand, and I think she did right there. See, look at the ball move. I mean, that angle was a great angle to see actually how much spin there was on the ball.
Twiddle had the pips out on the forehand side, the red rubber usually on the backhand. I don't know if she was thinking she'd have to come in and push with the backhand side. Let's watch one more time.
Yeah, I think it was just a change of mind at the very last second. She may have wanted to attack, but chose to. And two unforced kind of errors coming into the net. She was wanting to come forward, but two balls in the net gives Wang Yidi the 6-4 lead.
Yeah, Wang Yidi's hand's very good in the touch game. I feel like she's really putting pressure on Hitomi Sato with these short shots to the middle. I mean, after all, Sato had a big streak there, was leading 4-3 right after the towel break. Three in a row for Wang Yidi. Funny, we don't hear those flatter sort of slap chops from Hitomi Sato so often. This is good pressure from Wang Yidi. The amount of pace on that second forehand attack really turns it up a notch.
Just varying the placement on her chops was Sato on that point. There's going to be a lot of variation on the forehand topspins from Wang Yidi. Sometimes she's going to play the slower, loopy ones, and when she sees the opening, she's going to go for the quicker shots.
flat hit on the parallel. Sato with the aggression.
She has to show some aggression at some point because she can't just afford to play the defensive shots because Wang Yidi is too good a player to miss too many.
We talked earlier about how the Chinese team comes so well prepared for any style of play. A perfect shot on the turn here. I was reminded they have a protector. Their protector is Wu Yang. She's been the top chopper for the Chinese women for some time. And with a few other players coming up, some choppers, Liu Fei, for example, I think the Chinese women have no shortage of practice partners to make sure they get through choppers. Tomi Sato tied up at 7-all. Top edge, it will not come down on the table. Interestingly enough, I mean, this is why most teams will not send choppers to the Olympics against the Chinese women. They just figure the chances are so unlikely that they would win. Hitomi Sato beat Ding Ning, I think twice, in a few years just before the Olympic Games, yet still was not chosen for the Olympic Games. Standing attack here in the push play. What do you think, Varsha?
Yeah, I think she's won three of the last 4 points by playing the forehand smashes. She's managed to come up after playing 3, 4, 5 defensive shots. And as soon as she sees an opening, she's coming forward. And I think as soon as she comes forward, Wang Yidi is playing the slightly higher ball. She does not want her to attack, but she's just unable to keep the ball low enough across the net. Returns.
Oh, just lob. Just flirting with the baseline. These sky lobs. Sato showing what she could do. Cho Yiko watching, and the crowd's got to love this. We have seen, or at least I've seen, the Chinese women practicing against lobs quite a bit in the last 2 weeks. I mean, it seems like something you wouldn't expect to see them practicing, but they'll have one player lob from behind the table and the other smash over and over, and they are excellent against it.
Excellent play from Wang Yidi. She absorbed the attacking shots from Sato and then, you know, just turned defense into attack. Two balls played from two different flanks.
You know, Sato had won 4 points in a row from down 5-7 to have a 2-point lead. And as you mentioned, in the pushing rallies, Wang Yidi was, the ball would come up a little bit. Sato and her spin variation would earn opportunities to attack. See if she can get those opportunities here. Good use of side spin with underspin. A bit of that strawberry side spin. And it is game point for Hitomi Sato in a best of five. So an even more crucial game number one.
Yeah, she's done very well. She is mixing up defense with attack and keeping Wang Yidi guessing as to what kind of shot she's going to play.
An outright service point, a back and forth seesaw, game number one. A nice floating chop, a little bit less rotation on it than there appears.
And you were talking about, you know, rotating the racket, and that's the reason. There were times when the players would have the same color rubber on both the surfaces, but it's because of the twiddling of the racket that the defensive players used to use, or the players with the short pips used to use, is that actually they came out with the rule that you then have to have two different color rubbers on either side.
And in case you're curious what a twiddle is, watch where the rubber is on the racket. Turns it around. That was the twiddle. 180 degrees. Flips everything you thought you knew about what was where. Good luck with geography. Just long off that back edge. It's funny, in the United States there was a player, and still is a player actually, he's still competing, Danny Seamiller, who had a grip where it was very tough to tell what was on which side. And apparently in England, I want to say John Hamilton. Hope I got the name right there, but won the European Championships doing just what you said, twiddling with two of the same color. And he had a similar grip. So interesting.
Yeah, I mean, I'm so ancient that that was actually the time when I was playing, is that we could use the same color on both sides. But it was when a lot of some of the players started using the anti-spin, and then they started twiddling their rackets.
That's right.
That's when the change in colors came about.
Oh, the attack again. When she comes in, she means business. There's a lot of force behind the ball, not a lot of rotation on it. And it's tough to rally with Sato on the attack.
Side spin on that shot, gets the high ball, and plays the flat shot.
Good pressure from Wang Yidi. This is the first time we've seen an attack from Hitomi Sato that was more of a rally topspin shot. She also had a push with the long pips on the forehand, but the pressure on that last ball, just too much. Wang Yidi very confident in that last ball. She's a little bit behind the table. She uses that topspin more, and Wang Yidi is a bit more comfortable to keep that in play because it's a familiar shot.
She actually played the forehand attacking shot on Wang Yidi's topspin. Very good, but Wang Yidi just a little too strong on that point. Stayed close to the table.
Too much. She's close to the table, close to the net, and Wang Yidi in perfect position can play that wide angle out of reach.
First this extreme shot to the backhand, then the forehand, and then the final smash to the backhand again.
When Hitomi Sato lobs, if she can keep it baseline, she'll stay in the point. This one a little bit shallow. Wang Yidi taking advantage there. The parallel, still spin on it, but she shortens up the length on this, going to that short side of the table, and it pays off.
Yeah, variation on the forehand topspin. The first time I think we've seen Sato play the forehand topspin, but normally she's gone in with the forehand flat smash.
And in the last few rallies, she's done a few, but they were cross court, and they were comfortable for Wang Yidi to block. I mean, this rally was so good. There was just about every shot a twiddle could create just shy of a backhand loop, and Wang Yidi picking that one ball to finish.
Oh, what movement from Sato. Amazing shots. Three, four times, I think she changed the grip on her racket. She twiddled the racket three, four times during that shot. And sometimes you kind of, as a player, get confused yourself as to what am I doing.
I mean, if I ever put my car keys in my right pocket instead of my left, I'm like, oh, shoot, who stole my car? Where are my keys? And she's doing this just between shots in the rally.
Yeah, amazing.
I'm just kidding. I don't have a car. Seven serving four. ED with a three-point lead here. Good start, good midway through this game scoreline for Wang Yidi at the second towel break. She seems to be a bit more, well, I'd say avoiding getting into too many pushes. And I'd say the four-point run that we saw to put Hitomi Sato up 9-7 in game one. What did you see that Hitomi Sato was doing to keep Wang Yidi off the attack?
I think she was turning defense into attack during the end of that first game. She was looking at every opportunity when she could come in and, you know, put the pressure on Wang Yidi.
It's funny, when you think of choppers, you think way behind the table. But they need to stay close so that they can be a threat and can attack whenever the ball's left a little high. Loaded with spin, a lot on the shot before. Sometimes when you rally with the chopper, I mean, maybe it's just because I'm afraid, but in general, I won't attack two in a row. Physically fit, Wang Yidi's comfortable to attack several in a row, but you're just sort of compounding the spin on the ball when the chop comes back.
Yeah, because the more amount of topspin you put on the ball, the more amount of underspin there is which comes back to you.
There's that flat hitting forehand. She earns herself the position near the table, stays just close enough that she can get in and turn around and punish the attacker. And it's that little use of side spin there that mixes things up a bit. She's done a good job. You'll see her lift the outside of the racket, turn her wrist around the outside of the ball.
Yep.
Oh, perfect change of placement on the setup before this. The second to last shot has Sato on the chase. Wang Yidi looking strong.
Yeah, 3-4 consecutive topspins played by Wang Yidi. Really, really good control. Slightly high ball, and then she plays the forehand smash just out of reach of the Japanese player.
So Wang Yidi up by 3 second serve. You can hear the crowd gasp in this point. I mean, it's just not so often we hear that. I love watching choppers play. Classic choppers against well-prepared attackers out here. The fact that Sato won the first game, I mean, is quite a statement. There aren't so many choppers in the game. On the women's side, more than men's, but you just, with the Olympics having come up, the World Championships, I think Seohyo Won of Korea was a really starring chopper. But other than that, on the women's side, didn't see too many go quite so far. First time we had seen the backhand attack.
Yeah.
With the ball sitting up a little high. It was a long way to come in for this. Take another look at it from down here. Is the perfect angle to really appreciate how much time, or how little time rather. Well, from this angle, I would say most of the time, Hitomi Sato will make that shot.
Yeah, I think Wang Yidi was very relieved when that ball went long, bringing up game points for the Chinese.
There it is, only needs that first game point, 11-7. Wang Yidi levels the playing field at one game apiece. I was gonna say, what was your style of play, Vasha?
Oh, I was an attacking player. Loved the forehand topspin.
Beautiful attack here. Just got an interesting question from someone. Does being a chopper only take you so far? To be a champion, do you need to be an attacker? That's an interesting question. I'll send it over to you first, Varsha.
I think in the modern game, yeah, probably. But before, no, a chopper would have as much chance as an attacking player. It's just that there are slight limitations to what a chopper can do. But if he or she is willing to make the variations, come forward, play the attacking plays sometimes, I think they can be a great player. In fact, when away from the table, they can get a lot more balls back. The attacking players today are just slightly too powerful. The shots are so good. The equipment is so good.
And the finish to this point is so good for Hitomi Sato. That last attack once again. Take another look at it. The rally was quite long here. That last one arcs up just a little bit higher, so an invitation for Sato to come in. Yeah, there we've talked about the ball changes, you and I, maybe off the air. The balls used to be 38 millimeters, then 2000, just before the score change. They became 40 millimeters, and now 40 plus, which is about half a millimeter more in the measurement.
So 2000, the balls were increased in size, and then 2001, the game to 21 was brought down to the game to 11 to quicken the game.
And this is the diameter of the ball.
Yeah, yeah. And also, have you heard of the expedite rule, Adam?
Not only have I heard of it, it's my old coach's favorite quiz question for table tennis class at university. But yes, I'm quite familiar with the expedite rule and why it happens, but your thought?
Yeah, when the points were the first to 21, especially with games like this going on, I mean, if the game lasted more than 15 minutes, there had to be an end to it. So then the expedite rule would come into play. So if the game went more than 15 minutes, the person who served would have to finish the point within 15 shots. Within 13 shots, I'm sorry. Within 13 shots.
So now it's still 13 shots. But talk about it maybe after this highlighter on the towel break briefly.
Yeah, okay.
Wang Yibi changing it up there. A bit of side spin and top spin, and she hugged it around the ball just to change it up. So that was the towel break. So now 10 minutes of active play. If 18 points have not yet been scored, they will raise their hand, call time, and bring in a third umpire, someone who will stand next to the table. And then instead of every 2 points, the players will alternate serves every point. The serving player must end the point before the receiver has returned 13 shots.
Yeah,
and that
correct.
Third umpire will call every time the receiver puts the ball back on the table.
Yeah. That's actually so interesting sometimes, you know. Excellent play from Wang Yibi. Sato just unable to play the aggressive shot. Excellent return. I mean, she was backing off a bit, but managed to get the ball back in play.
Ooh, service point outright for Sato. I can't recall the last time we saw that. Maybe at the end of game number one, there were two. I forgot exactly how it went. I felt like there were two big points from 9-9 for Sato. And they would have been Hitomi Sato to serve at 9-9 because she took the receive. Oh, just long, spectacular point. A lot of work for Wang Yibi to win 1 point in this rally.
You know those lobs, they look easy to smash, but they are not, because the ball is bouncing so high. You have to get on top of the ball to actually play the forehand smash.
Right, and they're kicking so far away from the net that Wang Yidi jumping still doesn't have an easy angle down at the table. Not to mention it's so unconventional for you to raise your arm that high. Good placement here, jamming up Sato in the middle. The crossover point exists for defenders and attackers. Watch the placement on this last attack. Interesting.
Yeah, played right to her body, and the ball was just kicking off. Just played very deep as well. So almost on the edge of the table.
Two service points outright. I mean, we're seeing all sorts of differences. These fast, long kicking serves from the backhand.
Trying to play the flatter return, not playing the defensive shot, just trying to play a little bit of a topspin from behind the table. Last minute, she changed her mind. And Wang Yidi is taking a good lead, 8-4 in this game with two serves to come.
Oh, the power to finish. Wang Yidi worked so hard for that opportunity.
What an excellent shot from Wang Yidi. The one that hit the net. She just had to kind of make sure she got the ball back on the table. And when she saw this opening, the forehand smash finished it. Trying to play the inside-out forehand topspin from her extreme backhand side. Just try to go for too much. Try to go for the outright winner. Needs to be a little bit patient.
Third service point outright. This one, I mean, I don't know if it was even touched. That would have been the second ace we've seen in this session. Take another look. Fast and long. If touched at all, just barely brushed.
Nice forehand smash. She was in a defensive position, but moved forward very quickly when she saw the drop shot played by Yidi. Wow, you know, when we see the camera angle from the bottom of the table, that's when you can make out how strong they are.
Good placement here. Long push right out of the timeout, and Wang Yidi doesn't get anything easy to deal with. This is baseline. It is fast, and it is relatively empty. Necklace comes over there. Right at the baseline. Quick push, Sato changing it up. 1 point game now.
Excellent return.
Oh, Sato, what a point. Hanging in there for everything. Wang Yidi recovers. There was a long pips attack early in the rally from Sato. And then another defensive shot before she went back to chopping. I mean, to play from behind the table with long pips with anything but underspin is a recipe for disaster. That was the disbelief of that last shot not coming down. Don't worry, she's not injured. But she does have 2 game points against her on Wang Yidi's side. Serve has been effective so far. And once again, 4-5-4, okay.
All different kinds of spin and speed on those serves. One she played short, then a couple of times she's played to the extreme forehand of Wang Yidi. Just Wang Yidi had taken that time out, but she's going to have to try and close the game right here.
Game point saved, 1 more to go.
Ooh.
Oh, just misses the table. She knows it and drops in disappointment. 11 to 9. Sits up a little bit, but it is tough. It looks so juicy as it's just floating there, waiting to be crushed. But then again, Sato does her job of loading it with spin. Crush not. Two attacks in a row with the long pips from Sato. It was that side spin, though, that made it uncomfortable for ED. And
yeah,
the net, of course.
Yeah. And but the second shot following the net cord, I mean, that was a good shot. Ball veering away from ED's forehand side.
Looking for that attack. You can feel it when she comes into the table. I was a little surprised that it was from that deep behind the table that she found the attack that she was looking for.
Yeah, the first shot was played from deep from the table right here. And Yidi just couldn't cope with that pace.
First point here for Wang Yidi. Game four. Again, but these long, fast serves. I mean, in table tennis, if you're newer to the sport, you're not serving like in tennis directly over the net, not intentionally anyway. You have to serve it down into your side of the table. So to make it very fast and still stay on the table is not easy to do, but Sato has really shown how excellent she is in these fast, long serves. That one a little slower. First time in a while, I think, we've seen her slow down a serve.
Yeah, but what a good shot from Wang Yidi, the inside-out forehand topspin, going for the outright winner. She hasn't done that too many times in the last few points, but saw the opening, the ball just sitting up for her. Slight lack of concentration, I feel, from Wang Yidi. I mean, in the third game, she was able to play these shots. And just a slight lapse in concentration can actually make you, lose a few points in a row, which is exactly what's happened to Yidi.
Yeah, we often see timeouts there when a coach recognizes the concentration is waning. Topspin came in and Sato was that far to the forehand side. You could already feel how the story was going to end in this point.
Two balls from the extreme forehand from Wang Yidi, and this kind of, it wasn't a chop return.
Just the opposite.
Yeah, it was a counter return, and that's why Yidi could play the backhand cross court.
Yeah, the ball naturally sort of coming out faster into the racket of ED, so she doesn't need to put as much strength into it, just redirect, which is what she did. Roll reversal. Wang Yidi on the defense trying to make her way back in. Sato with the most attacks in a row we've seen in some time now.
And from well away from the table. One, two, three, and the fourth one was enough to win the point.
Backspins on the ball, different amounts of underspin here. Wang Yidi not able to do what she did to the topspin ball that came in. She has to generate her own power here and really move, and as you mentioned, focus for every shot because of those variations of spin.
And when you start to get a little tired, your mind gets tired, it's hard to focus on every shot.
This is one of my favorite things about playing choppers, is the mind game.
Yeah.
It's just such an unusual puzzle to figure out. Such a thinker's game, really. And it's physically exhausting. You might think, oh, the chopper's running around so much, she must be exhausted. But it takes so much leg strength and movement to set up for every shot as the attacker as well. Good pressure on the short side down the line. Yidi brings it back to within two. I think another reason it's so exhausting for the attacker is they're using muscles that they're not used to using as much. Against attackers, when you block, when you counter, it's very different than when you're springing upwards and lifting up the back of the ball the way you are here.
Yeah, and you're playing so many more shots against a defensive player. I mean, you don't normally play that against attacking players.
Right. That's a very good point. Much longer rallies against choppers. We're talking 3-4 shots on average against an attacker, but choppers, I mean, it could be 7-8, even up to 10. That's a tough way to come out of a timeout.
She tried to play the attacking shot, but so much off spin on that forehand from Wang Yidi.
The necklace has come back around completely. That's unusual. Could be a sign of stress or just focus, but when have you seen that? And then the follow-up. I mean, this is two devastating, powerful shots in a row from Wang Yi Di.
The third ball attack from her, the first topspin was strong enough, but look at the last one. There was so much of spin on the ball, there was no chance for Sato to return that shot.
This is survival mode now for Sato. I love this point. It's so well constructed. Wang Yi Di hangs in there for all sorts of variations. Side spin on the chops, deep to the corner. That was the side spin. Good coverage of the middle from Sato. Patience from Yi Di. We don't see too many points end in a pushing rally favoring Wang Yi Di.
I think she's now lost 4 points in a row, if I'm not mistaken. Hitomi Sato, she's still got 2 serves to come, but she has to buckle up here.
Oh, double happiness, the net and the back edge of the table. Wang Yi Di with some fortune. And if I heard you correctly before, from 4-7, that would be 6 points in a row now for Wang Yi Di. And the timeout was not enough to stop it. Wang Yi Di with 3 match points to move on to the semifinals. Close, a wry smile of a player who knew she was that close, had a good opportunity, and maybe, just maybe, is a bit over anxious here.
Yeah, how did Sato return that ball? At full stretch for her from her extreme backhand, and Wang Yi Di thought she had the winner, just a little long.
Still 2 match points left. Yi Di with the serves. Oh, the angle wide, she wraps it around and sends Hitomi Sato on a run. Zhongguo Jiayou indeed.